Tuesday, the 20th of July. I've just come down to the snake room after work, and Tallulah has made a massive mess in her enclosure. So, and she's managed to flip her water over. So let's get her out, clean her enclosure and get her back in again. It's absolutely boiling today here. But here, for us, it's hot anyway. For some of you people watching, it's probably not that hot at all, actually. But yeah, she's managed to tip her whole thing of water up and to make a massive mess. Hi! What have you done in here, you silly girl? Come on. So she's managed to loop herself around her probe as well. That's going to be interesting. Let's have you out of there. Come on. That's it. She's soaking wet. So there's Tallulah. Tallulah is a reticulated python. And how old is she now? Maybe, are you two? Are you two or three? But she's a gorgeous girl. So she is a titanium reticulated python that's currently soaking wet. And she's just recently shed, so I'll take her outside after this and see if I can get some nice pictures of her, because her iridescence is incredible in natural sunshine. So I'm going to clean her out. I'm going to kind of wrap her around my arm while I do that. So Tallulah will be getting a much bigger enclosure. I'm expecting to have quite a move around of the snake room in the near future. So she will be on list for a bigger enclosure. This one's fine for now, but she's definitely going to get bigger in the near future. She's escaping. So this is always interesting, trying to do this while holding her at the same time. But we'll get there in the end. So let's get this paper out and get her clean. She's just making her way across the trolley. Good girl, it's okay. So she's made a nice poo soup, which is always lovely. Let's get that in there. Absolutely honking. Doesn't help that it's really hot as well. Get in there, please. Most of it's on the floor. So, I wouldn't normally be using wet wipes, but I've run out of kitchen roll. So let's get in here. Get some of this mess out. And we'll soon have her clean and happy and sorted. She's just had a really good shed as well, so that's awesome. Let's just pick these bits up off the floor so that I didn't stand in them and trot them around everywhere. It is so hot here at the moment. Hot for us anyway. I've been in an air conditioned work environment all day. So coming into this, it's like hot. Obviously it's hotter than outside in here because of all the heat sources in this room. I'm going to leave that to air out a bit, take Tallulah outside and try and get some nice pictures. just had a nice stretch in the garden. She's just beautiful in natural sunlight. You can't explain it. It's just like rainbows. Love it. So let's get her enclosure kitted out again. You're a good girl, aren't you? Good girl. So this has a chance to air out a little bit as well, which is always a bonus. So I don't put her probe underneath the paper. I thread it in and out of her hide because otherwise she knocks it off. I've had a few issues with her enclosure getting too hot because she's quite active, which is why she's going to obviously be first on the list for a bigger enclosure. When I move things around, let's get this set up. Hopefully she's causing too many issues back there. So I'm going to give this a bit of a spray. Ooh. Get off of there, you. You're coming with me. Right. Let's give this a bit of a spray. A wipe off. And spray a water bottle as well, actually. This. She's not the most graceful of pines. Just give this a good wipe. So these upside down dog beds are perfect for bigger snakes. I was kind of fed up of looking for massive hides, and they're really expensive. So I got this one off of Facebook Marketplace for literally a couple of quid, and it's the perfect Tallulah hide. So I've run out of arm there to bring her back a bit, so let's swap over this side. So I do this probe, as you can see there's holes at the bottom of this hide, so I will go up from underneath, thread it through, and then go back down. Probably do that a couple of times because she's a nightmare with pulling it around. And I want the temperatures to be, you know, as accurate as we can. So I'll go out in it again, just to make sure that she's, what are you doing? Just to make sure that, that the probe's where it's supposed to be and the thermostat's doing what it should be. Obviously don't want her to get, and that's why her heat has gone off, because it's been unplugged by an escapee. So Cole, I was cleaning Cole out the other day, and I misplaced his lock. So I put everything back together and I thought I'll put that lock back on in a minute. Of course I forgot. And I got a message from my husband because I'd gone to work the following day, and he was out and about, so my husband had to get him back in again, which Cole's not very happy with doing, which quite amusing. So this bit of wood has been sat in wet, so I'm not going to put it back in at the moment. I'll give it a scrub and air it out before I put it back in, because it's damp at the moment. And I don't like damp wood enclosures, so I'm going to put Tallulah back and get her water bowl sorted. You go in there, darling. Go on then. Oh, I thought she was going to go in a hide. She's changed her mind. I'm sure she'll try and come back out. But that's all right. She's in exploring mode at the moment. Right, I'm going to sort this water out. So I've got a hose which fits most of the way. I've just been lazy and not taking enough off. So nice full water again. So holster that. Hi, gorgeous. lock on again in a minute. Right, that's two sorted. Okay, so next up is Tiggy. Let's see what sort of mood Tiggy's in. Don't really want any drama with him. And he can be a little bit of a knob sometimes. Let's see what we can do. Okay, come on you. Oh, and he is covered in poo, which I don't really want. But this is what we have to deal with, so that's fine. You go back over there, please. Oh no, this is not nice. I don't know if you can see that. Ooh. It's fine. Fine. Right, let's just gonna wipe that off a sec so that I don't get it all over me, which I certainly will when he starts climbing around. So let's get as much poo off as I can. There we go. Have you got any underneath there? Yes, you have. I'll have that as well, thank you. There. A bit on my hand, which is splendid. Okay, I'm going to move this a bit and then just have a little look and see. Okay, so I've got Tiggy out. Sorry about the fumbling around. I'm going to take this glass out, it's just a little bit easier to negotiate his enclosure and the filth within. So Tiggy, once he's out, he's fine, but I can feel a marked difference between how tense he is and how totally relaxed Tallulah is in the hand. And that's fine, he's just a little bit more edgy. He's a male. Yeah, and boys tend to be just that little bit more edgy. Female is just coming out of kind of breeding season at the moment, so I expect the males to be a little bit twitchy. You just have to be just that little bit more wary, which I always am with the boys. I always try to discourage people who are seeking male pets, just for that reason really. It's not because they are nasty or anything like that, it's just literally because they, you know, they have a one-track mind for some of the year, and friendly handling isn't really on their agenda. So I'm just gonna casually palm that. There we go. Right, let's have some spray. Just trying to walk with Tiggy on my leg, which is interesting. So I'm absolutely boiling because it's so hot in here. But we will persevere. Just try not to stand on Tiggy's tail because he will not enjoy that. Right, no, you can't. You can't come under there. Come back up this way. Whoop. There, let's. Oh, this is not working. We'll wait for him to come back up again. So, let's get some of this out while he's working out what he's up to. I'm scrubbing here. Believe it or not, I think he's actually eaten a full-sized chicken about 5 days ago, and he had a massive food lump. Like literally couldn't move type of lump, and it's completely gone, as you can see. You wouldn't even know that he's eaten it at all. So just goes to show for the correct temperatures and humidity how efficient they are at digesting big meals, which I just find quite interesting really. So this is a nice poo that he's kind of spread around the enclosure for me, which is very well appreciated. So I'm going to get all this off, because obviously with the heat as well, there's flies around. Don't want any flies getting in here. Certainly not having anything to lay eggs on. So it's really important at this time of year to make sure that the enclosures are really clean. In the winter you can get away with kind of leaving it a day, but in the summer, absolutely not. Get everything clean as soon as possible. Everyone's happy. Hi. Sorry about the sweaty mess, but this is life, I'm afraid. There are some very lovely, glamorous reptile channels that you can watch. If that's what floats your boat, but unfortunately that's not this one, I'm afraid. This is what you see is what you get here. Right, a couple more should do. I don't normally use wet wipes, as I've said. It's only because I've run out of kitchen roll. So I will let it air off before I put the newspaper in. This is going okay now. Random chicken feathers. What have you been doing in here? Oh. Right, well, we're taking the wood with us. Yeah, wood's coming with us. It's definitely going to trip me up in a minute. Oh God, Tiggy, you're heavy. You're a heavy boy. You're not going to see Beatrice. Thank you very much. She's not available for your attention. Oh, really? Right. Right, that's going to stay on the floor. Right, you've got to let this go. You can't have this. No. You can't have that. No. Be like this. That's better. Right. It's actually, because of the heat, it's actually dried out in there pretty good. So let's get in the bag. You've been a good boy, Tig. You need to grip that tightly, really. Right. Hi. Oh, I'm not sure I want you around my face. Thank you for that little headbutt. Just a little. Go. We're on to the other side, not ready for you yet. So I do have a big tub which I've been putting water in, which with retrospect would have been a good thing to do. No, you're not going down. Come here. Which would have been better. But, you know, sometimes you don't appreciate what you've done unless you really struggle. So, let's have you up here again, please. Sit. Tiggy's trying desperately to get on the ground at the moment, which is making my life tricky. Right, one more, and then we're winning. Yes, I'm winning. Did you hear? Come here. Right, settle down. Settle down. Right, where did I put your water bottle? Here it is. It's empty there. Right, so get this. Water. Right. We're on the home straight. Now, Do you need that bit of wood? You do like it, don't you? Let's put that back in then. I try and kind of angle it so it's sort of over his water bowl so he isn't quite so likely to flip it over, but it doesn't really work. Right, this is going to be the this is going to be the interesting bit, trying to get his glass in with him, trying to climb on it. Come on, come on, come on. In and in. Yes. Winning at life. Love it. Oh, Tiggy, you're getting heavy. Get him back. I'd normally clean the glass, but I'm a bit hot. So this is the gorgeous Tiggy. I mean, come on. Purple albino reticulated python. Just incredible. One of the nicest albinos, has to be, in all of the snakes. And what I love about these is they don't have those red eyes. So I dislike them, I just dislike them. I prefer these albino eyes to any other. Right, I don't like that stamp that you've got there going on, so get back. There we go, he's a good boy. There! Like, how dare you touch my tail? One, two. Okay. Gonna finish off the video with somebody a little bit more handleable. She feels tiny actually after holding the other two. This is Ginger. So she was my hard belly baby, and those of you that have seen a few videos will know she's got a scar here from an operation that she had when she wasn't really very old at all, to remove a hard lump of yolk which was in her tummy, which there was no way she would pass at all. It was kind of at least 10 times the width of her cloaca. No way she was going to pass. The advice initially was maybe put her to sleep because, you know, there was no way we could get it out. But I opted for surgery. She's had that, and as you can see, she's grown into a very healthy, gorgeous snake. I handle her and Tiny, who's her clutch mate, as much as I can. And this is about as good as it gets for a young reticulated python. Not head shy in the slightest. Really curious, so intelligent, very trusting, very relaxed in the hand, which you can't really ask for more than that, actually. So yeah, this is Ginger. I generally put quite a lot of spam of her on Instagram, just because with that overhead heat, she in particular really goes up. So first thing when you come down in the morning, she's up on her branch looking like a tree python, soaking up heat for the morning, and I turn the lights on, she soaks up that UV, which is just really nice to see those natural behaviours. So yeah, this is Ginger. Anyway, I'm going to leave it there. I'm boiling. I need to go and get in the shower. Thank you for watching. Like the video if you like it. Subscribe if you haven't already. I'd really appreciate it. Share these videos to other social media platforms if you think you know people that might enjoy them also, and I'll see you again.